Hello and welcome to the channel Elias Treasure of Knowledge. To get more videos on library and information science, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell icon. So in this video, we'll talk on preservation of print and digital library materials. Preservation is an indirect method or procedure which includes stabilizing, maintaining and monitoring temperature, humidity, light exposure, air pollution, dirt and dust. And mold preservation also includes scanning the proper storage and handling techniques, security, theft, disaster, prevention, education training and outreach programs for staff, patrons, client and the public. While conservation is a direct method or procedure in which an item is physically or chemically changed. This contains cleaning, repairing, rebinding, and reformatting. All conservation treatment encompasses the least intrusive method possible and the use of acid-neutral materials. The most detailed concept of digital preservation is storage, maintenance, and accessibility of digital material over a long period, usually applying one or more digital preservation methods. These methods may contain technology preservation, technology emulation, or date migration. And now we will see what are the objectives of digital preservation. So delivering continued access to digital material for both born digital and digitized materials, and assuring the authenticity of preserved digital material. Changing the digital information into a newer and fresher structure if necessary. Preserve physical media into digital media to prevent damage or deterioration by securing environmental control. And now I will tell you the types of preservation and conservation techniques. So two types of conservation and preservation techniques available. First is preventive conservation and second is interventive conservation. So let's see the preventive conservation. Many artistic works are sensitive to environmental conditions such as temperature, humidity, and exposure to light and ultraviolet light. Taking enough measures to protect materials in a controlled environment where such variables are maintained within a range of damage limiting level is called preventive conservation. And the second one is interventive conservation. Interventive conservation refers to any act by a conservator that involves a direct interaction between the conservator and the cultural material. These interventive methods involve cleaning, stabilizing, repair, or even replacement of parts of the original objects or materials. And now we will see what are the factors that damages library material. So the first is human factor, like handling, storage, repairing, and security. So let's see the preventive measure for human factors. Valuable books and ancient or important manuscripts should be kept in specially organized cabinet or shelf. Missing library materials such as books, films, etc. are one of the major problems in observation of the library material. Use bookend to support books when shelves are not full. Books should not be shelved too tightly or too loosely. Care should be taken while photocopying the books. Underlining must be avoided. For carrying a large number of books, trolleys should be used, and utmost care should be taken while handling or transporting rare, valuable, and delicate books. And the second one is chemical factors like alum, rosin, oxides of carbon, sulfur, nitrogen, hydrogen, and sulfide. So let's see the preventive measure for chemical factors. One of the best ways of controlling atmospheric pollutant is filtering of the air intake into storage areas, which can be attained by air conditioning system operating for 24 hours throughout the year. And the third factor is biological factors like microorganisms, insects, rodents. And the preventive measure for biological factor is avoiding food and drink inside the library. good housekeeping and care of optimum storage is necessary to control the propagation of insects. And the fourth one is environmental factor like light, heat, humidity and moisture, dust and dirt and water. So let's see the preventive measure for environmental factors. The sunlight and electric light should be prevented from directly on papers because of the ultraviolet rays. Air conditioning of the stack area should be maintained in optimum temperature and humidity for the storage of documents. During the summer months, when the temperature or heat is high, then the window should be kept closed. Adequate temperature to obtain both goals is 18 to 200 degrees centigrade and 65 to 68 degrees Fahrenheit. However, if possible, film and photography collection should be kept in a segregated area at 55 degrees Fahrenheit to 130 degrees centigrade. And the fifth factor is disaster like fire, floods, high winds, cyclone and earthquake. And the preventive measure for disaster is an expected natural or man-made disaster can harm the library materials. Some are preventable, some are not. It depends upon the library's administration that how they handle it. So we should establish automatic fire detection, extinguishing systems and water sensing alarm. Take special precaution during unusual periods of increased risk such as building renovation. Make special arrangements to ensure the safety of library or archival material when exhibited. Provide security copies of vital records such as collection, inventories and store these off-site. Protect computers and data through provision of uninterrupted power supply. And now we will see the advantages of digitization. So the first is remote access, which means connecting people globally by delivering continued free online access. And the second one is multiple accesses. So one of the most important advantages of digitization is multiple access. For example, if a manuscript is not digitized or it is in physical format, then only one person can use it in the certain period. But through the digitization process, many users can access the selected manuscript at a time. And the third one is storage saving. Through digitization, one can get rid of storage problems. And the fourth one is less chances of losses of materials. And let's see the barriers in digitizing. First is, in the initial stage of digitization, no one was ready to accept what digitization was. And so everyone was hesitating in submitting his or her manuscript for digitization. And the second one is, initially they used to send proposal to the public to send their manuscript for digitization, but now the system has changed. The request is being sent by the public. There is a need to create awareness among the public about the preservation of the archive so that this legacy can be handed over to the future generation. And the fourth and last one is, digitization requires a huge amount of money. Therefore, they have introduced a new scheme of adopting, which is one book for digitization.